Let's face it, not everyone is meant to be a programmer or a software developer, and that may sound astonishing to some, but the truth is, if everybody just starts to code, then the world will come to a halt bit by bit. Now, those of you who are getting ready to pick up your C++ hammers to break the computer screens, just hold it. I know that you have read numerous blogs on why everybody can learn to code and how everybody can learn to code, but that is as much as saying the sky is blue, and we all know that that's true. That's because the sky is not always blue. Take that into considerations. Everybody can learn to code, but that does not mean that everybody should become a computer programmer or a software developer. Maybe it might be just as enjoying coding, but not as a profession. Now, let's analyze some of the traits that shows that you are not fit for a programming job. Number one, you like regular work hours. In the software industry, one thing is particularly consistent, and that is inconsistent working hours. Whether you are working on your own hobby projects or working for an employer or getting something done for a client as a freelancer, you will really always have to pour in some extra hours of work. It's not like that. The regular 9-to-5 schedule of your office does not come into account. It's just that working for an extra hour to make that ninth line of the code work is pretty normal. And the truth is, most programmers just get used to it pretty quickly. And if you are someone who loves having regular office hours, 9-to-5, then maybe programming is not for you. Number two, you hate solving problems. Programmers/software developers do what they do due to one particular reason. They just love to grind their brains to solve problems. I mean, not every working hours is spent solving problems. Still, a decent amount of time can be attributed to it. If you are considering to get into the world of programming, just make sure that you like logic problems and love to solve them as well. Number three, you need a push to learn new things. One common trait of a decent programmer is that he or she is self-motivated. Be it learning a new programming language, getting to know a new technology, or just reading a programming book to expand their knowledge, good programmers will tend to do those on their own without anyone pushing them to do it. Often, developers find that they have to learn a specific technology to get something done for a particular project, but they would need it in the future after that. Still, they just jump on the learning train and try to wrap their heads around it happily. It's not easy to do something every day that you hate, and if you find that learning something new every day is too difficult for you, maybe you should consider changing your job to cook. And number four, you find it difficult to work in a team. If you are a programmer or a developer, then chances are that you are placed in a team with a specific goal to accomplish. In a team, communication is the most vital aspect. If you cannot express to other members in your team why something needs to be done the way you want it to be done, then you may find programming very frustrating. Most people think that a programmer just goes to work, grabs a cup of coffee, and sits in front of the computer all day, staring at the screen while his hand moves magically over the keyboard. That cannot be any farther from the truth. Yes, you spend a decent amount of time coding, but you spend even more time communicating your thoughts and ideas to others, because after all, a developer writes code for human beings, first for a computer, second. Number five, you are not good at listening to others' opinion. This is much of a continuation of the previous point where I talked about you find them difficult to work in a team. When you work as a developer in a place team, then the most important factor that determines the success of the project is constant and clear communication. It's just as important to listen to the ideas of your team members and clearly analyze why they want something to be done in a particular way. If you only keep pushing your ideas and belittle the ideas of others, then chances are that the other team members may find it difficult to work with you. But what if you're working as a freelancer? In that case, the ideas and opinions pitched by your client should be respected. It may be the case that your client is not as a very, you know, like a tech savvy person, and in that case, it is the duty of the programmer to make the client understand why something would or would not work when it's done in the particular way that the client wants it to be done. So listening to others should be another quick checkpoint of a good programmer. Number six, you are doing it for the money. Okay, everybody knows that software development is a very high paying industry, but if you are in it only for the money, then my friend, you are going to get very frustrated and burn out really quickly. None of the developers out there do it for the money. Now, some of them may say they are in the software development for the money, but the truth is, deep down, they just love programming and software development in general. Can you even believe when somebody says that they grind their heads in front of a computer 10 to 12 hours a day so they'll just get paid every month? No, every developer just loves the thought of creating software and products from an idea. So think again, whether you are doing it for the money. If yes, then try find something else that you're really good at other than coding. Now, on a final note, this video is not to demotivate anyone from learning programming or sticking to their programming job. I just want to make some of you aware that there might be a better job out there for you other than coding, and we're just gonna get you more impact impact that and fulfill them. Maybe you can become like a better digital marketing expert, but because you love technology in general, so you are holding on to the programming job, something like that. There can be many reasons as well why you might not also want to leave your coding. It's totally up to you, and it's what you can do that I'd advise you do. Still, deep down, if you believe that you actually love programming but you have some of the above mentioned traits, then do not worry at all. You have all the chances to improve in those areas, and it's very certainly possible. You just have to invest time and be willing to change. That's it. And after all, we are humans, and humans have evolved and can evolve to achieve something that's really strive for. So that's it for this video. Hopefully you enjoyed it and learned something new. And if you did, don't forget to drop a like and a comment, and also consider subscribing, as that will really mean the world to me and help my channel grow. And I hope I'll see you guys in the next video where I drop some more amazing content just like this one. Make sure to drop a like, and you're gonna follow along with each video weekly. And I hope I'll see you guys in the next video. Mad love, peace out.